All right, if you're a Mountain Blade fan, prepare to be deeply rectally irritated. I'm just kidding. You can relax. I like the game. I'm not gonna trash it. It's a very good game. By the way, I'm talking mainly about Warband, but I'm just going to say Mountain Blade because it's shorter. I guess I should say Warband because it's even shorter, but whatever. M&B. I don't care. It's one of the games with the most realistic fighting. And this is one of the most frequently asked questions that people have. How realistic is the fighting in Mountain Blade? Well, it's known for its realism, and for a video game, it is quite realistic in a lot of ways. The way the characters move is perfectly possible. They don't make somersaults all the time, or backflips, or spins. They don't jump 30 meters high, or anything like that. They move like human beings do, to an extent. You have to take into consideration the limitations of the game. It came out in 2010, so it's 8 years old by now. And the gameplay, to me, feels a little bit stiff compared to some newer games. Again, nothing that I would fault the game for, considering its age. And it did what it does pretty well overall. So the short answer I'd give is yes, Mountain Blade is realistic, considering the limitations of the game and when it came out, and also considering the limitations of video games overall when it comes to realism. There is only so much realism that you can implement without affecting the enjoyment of the game negatively. You always have to balance gameplay with realism, and there's only so much realism that is really appropriate or quote-unquote necessary. Obviously, none of it is necessary, but it can add to the enjoyment to some people. Everybody has different opinions, of course. So, yeah, if you're just here for the short answer, you might as well leave now. But if you're still there, I'm gonna go into a bit more detail now. Also, as a side note, the weapons and armor in Mountain Blade are very realistic and go pretty far in terms of historical accuracy. It's not supposed to be exactly the same. It's not actually historical planet Earth. It seems to be some alternate kind of thing where the different factions have different names, which are clearly inspired by historical cultures. But it also mixes some time periods together to have greater variety of equipment, which makes perfect sense. You don't want to limit it to just one time period because that limits the number of different arms and armor that you can have quite a lot. So that is perfectly reasonable, and everything is properly shaped and it looks right. So there's nothing out of the ordinary that I've seen, and a lot of attention to detail. From what I've seen so far, if you want the highest level of realism in games, you need scripted movements. If you just have disjointed movements, like, okay, this button does that attack, and that button does that attack, it's never going to look quite as smooth as if you have a scripted combo, like the way it is in Kingdom Come. You don't have to 100% control every little aspect of every movement. That gets a bit much. You just do a certain combination, then the character goes through that combo in a pretty smooth way. So that's useful if you want to include some more complex movements, and also especially things like grappling, wrestling, and historical techniques that come from angles that would be difficult to control. Also things like binding with the opponent's blade, winding into a thrust from there, or controlling the opponent while doing a cut at the same time. Those would be pretty much impossible with the more traditional, if you will, direct controls the way you have them in Mountain Blade. Also, one thing that limits the realism a little bit in Mountain Blade is you only have horizontal and vertical cuts. Now, that's not the most common by far. The most common cut in sword fighting is diagonal. This is the most useful, most versatile. It's harder to evade, because if you cut straight down, like vertically straight down, all the opponent has to do is step to the side, whereas the diagonal cut is going to follow them a lot more, and it can displace the opponent's cut, and a number of things. It's much, much more common than the horizontal cut, or the vertical for that matter. Also, with this kind of gameplay, you can't do active defense, which I've really only seen in Kingdom Come so far, meaning that you strike the opponent at the same time as they cut or thrust toward you, displace that and strike them all in one motion. That can't really be done, and that's one of the most effective defenses that you have in historical combat. And by the way, if you haven't seen my video on defenses in historical swordsmanship, I'm going to link that down below, along with some other interesting stuff. And one of my final nitpicks is one of the parries, or more of a block, really. It's a static block. Now, the way they do it to the side is fine. You can block cuts like this, particularly undercuts, but you can also defend against a downward cut like this. It's called absetzen, or setting aside in the German longsword tradition, where you basically cut into the opponent's cut to displace it and keep yourself safe. That can also be done statically if you have to. The high block, on the other hand, is a lot less useful. It looks something like this. They have it horizontally in front of their face, pretty close to the head, and there are a number of issues with it. For one, the hands are a pretty easy target here, because all the opponent has to do if they cut here is just adjust a little bit and strike to the hands instead. Also, the point isn't doing anything to threaten the opponent, so if they push the offense and just move in and throw one cut after the other, you don't really have anything to stop them with. You're just defending yourself. And the third thing is, because it is so far to the head, if somebody strikes forcefully, they may just break through and strike you in the head anyway. If the guard position is further out, on the other hand, it's a lot more useful in a number of ways. See, the point is a lot more forward. The blade is still protecting me, and it is further away from me to offer a greater cone of defense, if you will. But this can also discourage the opponent from moving in. Like, do you want to move in on this point? You don't, right? Anyway, so this is very nitpicky and too much detail just for those people who asked about it and wanted to know. But otherwise, you know, you can't fault the game for lack of realism at all. I mean, arguably, you can't fault any game for lack of realism unless it is setting out to be a simulation of some sort. If the game claims to be historically accurate, that's a different story. But a game like Mount Blade is inspired by history, but it's not claiming to be authentic in that way. But it's perfectly realistic as far as the limitations are concerned. And it makes lots of sense, and it's a good game. So that's really all I can say about it. And I'm sure we're all eagerly waiting for Bannerlord, right? Anyway, hope you enjoyed this. Thanks for watching, and have a good one, folks. Also, check out the links below. It's good stuff. Thank you.